Hello everyone, welcome to Design Gorithm. I am Shelly. Today I am going to show you how to draw a one-point perspective in Procreate. I have simplified the process into 7 steps. First, you have to choose a canvas. Second, you have to create layers. There could be several different ways to draw in Procreate. The method that I am showing here is going to use less layers. That means even if you are using an older version of iPad, you will still be able to make this sketch. And if you are using iPad Air or Pro, you can go with the non-destructive workflow in which you can create separate layers for shadows and highlights, and afterwards you can merge them into one. So all depends on how you like your work. Third step will be to set up drawing guides. And fourth, you have to draw the basic sketch first. And the fifth step will be to trace the final drawing with correct layer selected. Sixth, you have to add a base color. And then seventh and the final step will be to add shadows and highlights. Let's see how we can do this. For drawing a perspective view in Procreate, if you are drawing a one-point perspective, you need one vanishing point. Or two vanishing points if you are drawing a two-point perspective, and you will be needing drawing assist. You can choose the canvas size from the given options, or you can create your own canvas. For that, you have to click this icon. You can specify size in pixels or inches or centimeters. Now in the layers panel, you can adjust the background color if you want. You can rename layers. Now you have to do some canvas settings by going into the preferences. You have to turn on drawing guides, and then you have to edit these drawing guides according to your preferences. You can choose perspective grids and click on the canvas to create a vanishing point. You can move this point as per your suitability. You can adjust the opacity, thickness, and color of these guidelines. Now choose a brush to start sketching. Choose color from the color palette and adjust the brush thickness. Turn on drawing assist. Now you are all set to start your perspective sketching. Now what we are going to draw in this video is this sketch. To draw this, I first chose a custom canvas. Then I created some layers. I initially started with the sketch layer, which I deleted afterwards. Also, I made all the settings for one-point perspective as I told you before. Let's start with the basic sketch. I am going to create walls, windows, door frames first. Now I will draw wall panels. I will draw the basic sketch or line drawing of L-shaped sofa and a single sofa, as well as a center table. Now I will make a new layer and start tracing over the basic sketch. Create separate layers each time, rename them. Now the tracing is over. I will create a new layer for coloring and rendering. First, I will render the sofa. Choosing a brush and color from the palette, I will create a base color. I will turn on the alpha lock and start creating shadows and highlights with a soft brush. Do the same steps for cushions as well. Now on a separate layer, you can render accessories and artifacts following the same steps. That is, create a layer, choose brush, apply base color, Then choose Alpha Lock and add highlights and shadows. The order in which layers are placed is also very important. With proper layer structure, it becomes easy to manage your drawing. So I guess this was pretty simple. Hope you liked and understood the process. Try it. And if you find any difficulty, you can write in the comment section. I will try to help you. And if you really like the video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to find more videos on my channel. Thanks a lot.